We continue our look at topic two, the ecosystem, and this segment is concerned solely with topic 2.3.1, which is to construct simple keys and use published keys for the identification of organisms. So let's find an organism that needs identifying. Suppose you were out doing a study of a polluted pond or lake, and you found this floating as a result of maybe runoff from a farm, and your job was to identify the species that you're looking at so that you can go ahead and write a report of what's going on. Your first step is likely to be take a sample of it to the lab and look at it with the microscope. When you look in there, you are likely to find this. This should tell you that you are looking at algae, provided that you've got some basic knowledge of what you're doing. And algae have chloroplasts in their cells, lots of the green stuff used in photosynthesis. And this particular algae that we have is made up of long unbranched filaments. With this basic information in mind, our next step in identification is at this key and see if you can figure out how it works just by looking at it. This, of course, is a very simple version of a dichotomous key, and the content of this is adapted from this URL here at the bottom. So if you've had a look, maybe you figured out how it works, but this is how it works if you're having any trouble. The key, the dichotomous key, is made up of a series of statements, and each set of statements is aimed at dividing the big group into smaller groups so that you can eventually zero in on the identity of the unknown species that you're trying to identify. For instance, what we found in the pond is microscopic. It's not macroscopic. We needed a microscope to see details of it. So the first statement or pair of statements, which is why we get the name dichotomous, branching into two, the first pair of statements says microscopic or macroscopic, and our response should be that it's microscopic. So that means that we are directed to go to number two, which then asks, does it contain chloroplasts or not? And it does contain chloroplasts. So we go to three, and in three are the cells solitary, which means just by themselves, or are they in colonies, or are they filamentous? Well, we might not be sure about what a colony is, but if it's grouped with solitary, we've already identified that the algae is filamentous. So that takes us to five, long, thin, unbranched filaments. So that takes us from five over to seven. And at seven, we're asked, are the chloroplasts in a spiral like a spring, or are they not in a spiral? And we don't have any evidence that they're in a spiral. So that leads us to eight. Do we have single chloroplasts or many small chloroplasts? And you can see here that our specimen has many small chloroplasts. And that leads us to identify our specimen as microspora. And this is how you use a simple dichotomous key. Having used it, though, you are likely to be asking, why a key? Why do you need to go through this system when maybe you can just look through the pages of a book or go online and search for kinds of algae. And that could very well work if you just had maybe 50 types of algae to pick from. That could certainly work. Or maybe even 100. But if you had 8,000 species and more of algae, it could be a bit time consuming. Think about looking for somebody in a town with 8,000 homes. It would take some time to carry out your search. But if you had some important information about who you were looking for, and each time you asked a question of somebody, it narrowed your search down, then it will be a whole lot easier. So this is what a dichotomous key does. It takes information that you know, simple information that you can observe, and it very quickly allows you to move toward identifying the name of what you have in front of you trying to figure out. The keys are usually made by biologists for biologists. So in the real world of biology and trying to identify things, it's definitely an asset if you have a basic knowledge of some of the terms, like the terms we've used here to understand a key, like microscopic and macroscopic, to know what chloroplasts are, to know what filamentous means, what solitary and colonial mean. That would also be helpful. So a basic understanding of the structure of what you're looking at certainly is helpful, because ultimately, to identify, we have to work with things that are easy to observe. It's no point talking about things that are really complicated and hard to see. We would like to quickly identify what we're looking at. So let's stop here now and have a look at your activity. Your activity requires you to make a key for 8 organisms that you are hopefully very familiar with: beetle, scorpion, centipede, ant, dragonfly, ladybug, spider, and butterfly. So go ahead and look back at our sample key. Look at how it's made up with pairs of statements, and try to organize our 8 specimens here in a key of your own. And a hint is to look for features like body segments, wings, and legs, things that are easy to observe and would be very useful in separating the members of this group. Your answer doesn't have to exactly match this to be right. So you could have a very good answer that does not match this. And if you have it totally wrong and you think you need another shot at this, go to your refrigerator and take out some vegetables or some food items and try making a key to identify the names of what you have in the refrigerator, for maybe for the purpose of some alien being that you have staying with you who won't know the names of what's in the refrigerator, but they might be able to identify some of the features.